Hello students, in this video I'll talk about the expert system. This video contains the domain knowledge, representation of the domain knowledge, expert system shell and the knowledge acquisition. So what is the expert system? The expert system is basically deals with the knowledge domains the domains contains the few facts about some particular area, and a few rules are there based on the situation. Which rules are being applied, based on that the corresponding actions are taken. So this is how the expert system is dealing with. And the expert system is basically a computer program where it is working like a human brain. Students, we know that we have to take such decisions based on the situation and the domain knowledge we already have. Suppose you are giving some examination and few questions has come which is partially included in your syllabus, and which is not included, that part you may know, partially you know, but not that much. So if you want to attempt that questions, then you know that you will not get good marks. So what the action will take? Rules is that conditions is that the question is not common, so you must have to go for the another question which is common and given as an option. So this is how the expert system is dealing with. So basically the knowledge of the expert system came from the human experts. We all are the experts, but maybe sometime we forget about some domain knowledge and later we think that no, I forget that, so because of that the decision was taken wrong. But in the computer expert system, it never takes any wrong decision, as it searches all the corresponding knowledges which is already stored in the knowledge database. So in this way it is working. So what is the, if we compare the expert system with the human expert, then the based on the time it is limited for the human expert, but an expert system can work anytime, anywhere. Location is anywhere, where whether the human expert time is location is specific. Safety is we can say that the expert system can be replaced, but the human experts cannot be replaced. And based on the damage, that damage is not there for the expert system, as we already store all the data, but the human expert may forget some data. And the speed of efficiency may changes for the human, but it is consistent for the expert system, as it is a machine, a computer program. And cost is high for the human expert, but it is moderate in the case of expert system. So this is the architecture of the expert system, where the knowledge database and the inference engines are there, which apply some rules. And here the user basically trying to know about some facts or give some facts that it is there, what should I do. So the expert system works as expertise and give some suggestions to the user. So this is how the expert system work. For example, let us take the example of the traffic rule, where if the traffic light is red, then we have to stop. So this is the manual if else conditions, if then condition is there. So similarly, we can use the if then statement in the computer program also. For example, if condition 1 and condition 2 and condition 3 etc. are there, then we will take the action. Or it may be like this: if condition 1 and condition 2 or condition 3. So using the AND OR case, we can replace any kind of conditions, and based on that we can take the action. So these types of rules and the corresponding action should be there in the system. So strategy of designing the expert system are two. One is forward chaining strategy, another one is backward chaining strategy, where in the forward chaining strategy the set of target is unknown. We are only having the set of actions and rules and the mapping function, but in the backward, but we do not know about what the result will come. But in the backward strategy, we know the result, how the system works and what should be the exact answer should become. And based on one system, suppose we want to design another system, so the same pattern we will follow for that case. So we know about all the outputs. Based on that we design the inputs. So that is the backward chaining strategy can be used for designing the expert system. So the characteristics of the expert system is flexible, robust, reliable, and easy to understand. It should be based on the domain knowledge, so it should be easy to understand for all the users, and the expertise should know for all the programming language so that it can be user friendly, and the system should react on the right time, on the right case. So these are some characteristics of the expert system. To develop the expert system, we must have some domain expert. The domain expert may not have the programming knowledge. The domain expert may not have the computer, or may not have any idea of the computer program, but the domain expert must have the domain knowledge, and based on that domain knowledge, the knowledge engineer, for example the programmer, will design the system. So domain expert is one person who knows about one person or the set of people who knows about the what exactly it need, right? So this is the domain expert is. And the knowledge engineer is basically who knows about the programming code correctly. So which programming code is applicable where, which tools are applicable, that should be there in the knowledge engineer. And the user, obviously we need some set of users who will test the system properly. So this is what exactly needs for developing the expert system. And as an application, we can say that there are huge areas where the expert system nowadays are using. Two examples I have written over there. One is the banking or financial sector, where the banking manager should take some quick decisions or quick controls over the system. That is very much proper thing. Like a banking manager wants to see the approve the loan, and he wants to check that person's history of taking the loans and giving the loan amount to the bank. So based on that he is taking the decision, so he can use the expert system for that decision. Next example is the production industries or the militaries, where some conventional or some enterprise editions are used, where they want to take some big decisions. Based on that, based on their requirement, and that helps small mechanical items, or it identifies some threats or risk. So these are some examples of the expert system where the it is being applicable. So if you like my video of the expert system, then do subscribe my channel for the upcoming videos on artificial intelligence and the another sections. Thank you so much.